Welcome to Monster Movie Night. I'm your internet horror host, Bobby Gammonster, and my co-host, Boris T. Buzzard. Thank you, one and all, for coming
Bobby.
Here again. What?
Bobby.
Danvers, is that you? Are you still here?
I'm still here. So, I'm having a little trouble with everything. You see, I'm gaining a little bit of my sanity back, and everything seems to be a little bit more prim and proper than it used to be.
Oh dear, it's infectious. It's infectious too. I'm almost starting British, but don't worry, my twang will still be here.
So I was wondering if you and Boris could help me out a little bit so that I could get back to my regular old self again.
Yes, we can't we, Boris? I mean, after all, you helped us last time. I mean, my name and everything, it's Bobby Gammonster.
Yes.
Yeah, you know.
I'll tell you what, if you can help me rid of all of the prim and proper and sane stuff, I will move out of your hearse and go back to the asylum. After all, I'm getting a little bit too much fresh air out there, and I think that's what's contributing to all of this peace and normalcy. I want to go back to my old self again.
We need you back to your old self again, and I'm sure that the demented features in the asylum there need you back as well.
Yes.
So yes, we can help you out. We have plenty of non-fresh air.
Yes.
Plus, we have tonight a film called The Anatomy of a Psycho.
Ooh.
And so that should help start us. But we shall also go to the lab when we come back for our break.
That'll be perfect.
So, let's go to Anatomy of a
Psycho.
These go to you.
Say, what's it like inside?
Just leave me alone.
Come on, lay off. What is he, a celebrity? All I did is ask him a question. I asked you a question. What's it like inside?
Get your hands off of me.
You Marcos are real tough. Hey, you guys want to see a real killer here? Real killer. My brother didn't kill anybody. Your brother was a punk killer. Imagine let us down for everything he's done for us. He said to kiss you goodbye. Pat, what do you think he said? What time is it?
11:15.
Pat, do you realize in 45 minutes my brother's gonna be dead?
Oh, Chet, I know it's hard, but try not to think about it.
You finished yet? Gotta get out of here.
Listen to me. Don't start running. Duke's my brother, too, and I love him. But he killed a man. And now he must pay what the law says he must pay.
He didn't do it.
What?
He didn't do it. He didn't do it. He told me.
Duke said that?
That's right.
That's crazy. I don't know why he did this to you, but he was lying. Maybe for some reason he thought you'd feel better, but he was wrong. He killed that man.
Don't say that. No, he wouldn't lie to me.
He did.
He raised you just like he raised me. And you know he wouldn't lie to me.
Yeah, please don't go. No, not tonight. Please.
Patty,
let me out. No, Chet, please, Patty. Chet? Oh, please come back. Please. Please.
Well, you better turn in, son. Don't overdo it.
Dad, I wish he didn't have to die.
That's not in our hands.
But it was in yours. Mike, you're wrong.
I've never known you to be this unreasonable before.
Mike, I saw a man with a gun kill another man. It was my duty to tell what I saw. I couldn't live with myself if I didn't. Can you live with yourself knowing you're sending a man to his death?
I'll just have to. Mike, you're taking this awfully hard. Is Duke Marco's brother such a close friend of yours?
No, I've just seen him around school once in a while.
Then what is it?
Dad, nothing. Except why couldn't you have said that you weren't sure, or you couldn't see us, something?
I'd be lying.
Dad, I don't want to live here anymore. I don't want to see anybody or know anybody around here.
Son, it was a closed trial. My testimony was confidential. Nobody knows anything about it. In an hour, it'll be a closed issue.
Good night, Dad.
Mike. I'm very disappointed in your attitude toward me.
I know you got one here somewhere.
Man, the cupboard's bare.
Break it out, Mo. I'll give you a dollar.
All right. Not the dollar. Thought he shouldn't. But easy, man. It's not going out of style.
Not you. Go ahead, Chip. Drink.
I wasn't gonna drink.
We interrupt our program to bring you a special news bulletin. Time has run out for Duke Marco, hold-up slayer of Harold Foreman. As was expected, Governor Creighton refused to grant a stay of execution, and the condemned killer will die as scheduled at state prison at midnight tonight. As the last seconds of Duke Marco's life draw to a close, what are the thoughts in the mind of the condemned man? Does he feel remorse for his brutal crime as he tries to make his peace with God? As the state prepares to exact the extreme penalty for an act of murder, this reporter has cause to reflect on the crime and the criminal.
I'm going to smash all of them. I'm going to smash them. I'm going to smash all the witnesses. I'm going to smash all of them.
We'll get them, Chet.
Danny? Danny!
DA, son?
Of course I'm sure. That's his car.
He's in there studying?
Every day. He comes out about 6 o'clock. I know because I've been here before.
Okay, get where you belong.
Let us help.
Do as I say.
Chet, maybe we
do what I told you.
All right, now you watch for trouble.
You want my money?
Get out of the car. Oh. Slowly.
Are you guys? Oh, come on, say something. You picked on the wrong guy. Maybe you don't know who I am. My father's a district attorney. You could get in a lot of trouble.
I'm sorry, honey. I wanted to.
Then why didn't you? Is it because of... Mickey, are you ashamed of me?
Ashamed of you? Honey, is that what you've been thinking?
I've been so worried.
Honey, it's my fault.
I thought you didn't want to see me anymore, that you were embarrassed.
Honey, nothing could make me ever feel that way.
Then why didn't you call Mickey?
Well...
Please, won't you tell me what's the matter?
Honey, it's something about my father that you don't know.
He doesn't want us to see each other anymore, huh?
No, it's nothing like that. Look, let's forget it. We're back together again, and that's all that counts.
I think we have a few things to talk about.
Patty, I got a lot of things on my mind.
Oh, I have too, and I want to talk about them.
Let me eat in peace, huh?
Oh, Chet, I never see you anymore except when you come home to eat. Couldn't we at least talk now?
check. Oh, okay. We'll see you. Well, thanks, Pat.
Listen, Chet. I've been thinking. I'd like to see you go back to school. No, listen. I'm a girl. I need to go. I could get a job and you could quit yours.
Things are just fine the way they are.
No, they're not, Chet. There are some things that you don't seem to understand about Duke. He wasn't like what you think.
He's dead. Can't you leave him alone?
Oh, Chet, you've turned him into some sort of crusading hero. He wasn't like that.
He kept us out of an orphanage. He raised us. He didn't have to do that.
Don't you think I know that? But I also know how he did it.
What's the difference? He's my brother, and what he did for us.
Duke was a hoodlum. He beat people. He robbed them. And he finally even killed a man.
He ate his food. You lived in his house, and you spent his money.
I was a kid just like you. What did you expect me?
You're a hypocrite, a lousy hypocrite. I gotta get out of here. If anybody else has said the things you said, I'd kill him.
Chet, please stop it. Whatever you're going to do, please stop. For me. All right, then, not for me, for Duke.
From here on in, everything I do is for Duke. Try and understand. If you can't, just leave me alone.
And too well, Chet. Grow up before it's too late. Hello?
Hi, honey. This is Mickey.
Oh, Mickey.
Yeah, I'm going to talk to you.
Could you come over?
Let's take a ride or something.
Chet?
Yeah, come on out.
Go away.
What?
I said go away. It's too late.
What do you mean it's too late?
Shh, wake my mother up.
If you don't get out here, I'm going to wake the whole neighborhood up.
Wait a minute.
It's just too late, Bib.
I can't see you anymore, Chet.
And why?
My mother, she says I shouldn't.
Never mind what your mother says, baby. What do you say?
I feel the same way.
A new friend?
Yes. Well, what do you expect? I don't see you for weeks at a time, and when you do come around, it's always like this. You never take me any place.
So?
So I'm moving in new circles now. Class. Something you wouldn't know anything about.
Class, huh? It's something we both understand.
shit, you really clobbered that guy.
It made the papers.
It made it. It's monopolizing them.
They left wild front page. DA's son is victim of hoodlum assault.
Walter Lee Baker, son of Lawrence Baker, city district attorney, was found last night the victim of a brutal beating.
Hey, Chet, you brute, you.
Investigating officers have ruled out a robbery motive since Baker's wallet and watch were untouched.
Oh, wow. We forgot the bread.
Come on, knock it off.
What's the matter, Chet?
Cool it, Mo.
Yeah, I'm looking for Chet Marco.
So, what do you want from me?
Well, he's a friend of mine.
I know all of Chet's friends. Take off.
All right, let him in, Mo.
You know this flower?
Yeah, I know him. Chet, can I talk to you? All right, talk.
Well, it's a little personal.
Well, what about?
Well, would you step outside?
I think he wants to whisper sweet nothings in your ear.
I don't think I like you.
Give me the word, Chet. I'll throw him out.
What do you want, Mickey?
But Pat wanted me to ask if you'd like to go to a party this afternoon.
Party? That's marvelous. What time are you picking us up?
Are my friends invited?
Well, it's not my party. I couldn't do that.
Well, I don't go anywhere without my friends, Mickey.
Hey, would you invite us if it were your party?
No, I don't think I would. Look, the party's at Arthur Brennan's house. Now, you can go with Pat and me, or you can go alone. Arthur Brennan's house?
Look, Chet said you don't go where his friends aren't welcome.
I like you less and less.
And I'm heartbroken.
Look at clown, I came to talk to Chet.
You came to my house.
All right, easy,
Chet.
Mo.
Get out.
All right, easy, Mo. Chet!
Well, you never know these days when you're going to get a laugh. I thought I'd break you boys up.
You're a million laughs, Lieutenant.
How are you? Well, here's a new face. I hope I wasn't interrupting something.
What is this, the Pentagon? You know, I live here. Chet, as far as the party, the invitation still goes. And I hope I see you real soon.
Anytime, punk. But don't come to my house again. Unless you bring Pat.
Look, you mentioned Pat once more, and I'll be here a lot sooner.
Hey, rough guys invading the territory, Lieutenant. I may need your protection.
A Marine veteran need protection? I doubt that.
You come here to shoot the breeze, Lieutenant?
Yeah, sure. What else?
You look a little unhappy.
Well, now that you mention it, Chet, I am, as a matter of fact. Pretty terrible thing happened yesterday.
Yeah?
Yes, the boy got roughed up quite a bit. On my beat, no less. And to make matters worse, he's the DA's son. The powers that be are awful disturbed.
That's real tough.
Yes. I see you already know about it.
Yeah, we read the headlines.
Is that all you know?
That's all.
Buy the papers every day, keep up with the news, huh?
Look, Mac, circulation's 180,000. A lot of people buy papers. We were just looking to see where we could go to the movies.
Yeah, well, that's a nice idea. Tell me, fellas, have any of you ever seen this before?
Put it on again, Lieutenant. It's an improvement.
No, you got a real wit about you. It's an improvement. That's a good one, huh?
Lieutenant.
Yeah.
We don't know anything about the DA's son or the mask.
Dickie, could I trouble you for a glass of water, please?
Sure.
I suppose you fellas can account for your whereabouts yesterday about six.
Six? You were here, weren't we, Danny?
Yeah, you went home about 6:30.
You got witnesses?
Sure. Mo, Danny, Pete, Dick, and Bobby.
Well, how are you, Bobby? I hardly noticed you there.
Oh, okay. Any other questions?
No, I guess none. But if you should happen to hear of anything that might help.
Hey, try the scorpions. They're real tough studs.
Yeah, I know they are, Mo. Thanks.
Hey, Lieutenant, it behooves me to ask one question. Did you check the mask for fingerprints?
Yes. Go on, Danny. Hey, Chet, what movie did you decide on?
Crime and Punishment.
That's a real good movie.
I don't like the heat waltzing into my pad.
Well, don't sweat it. He all but told us he doesn't have anything on us. He's on his way now to bug somebody else. Mo, you know who Arthur Brennan is?
No, he didn't invite me to his party.
He's Judge Brennan's son. I'm going to that party.
Who's there?
Oh, it's me, Dad.
What is it? Something happened to the car?
No, everything's all right. Can you come out here a minute?
Okay, Mike.
So nervous, I don't know what to say to him.
Just say hello, Mr. Craig. Something must be wrong. Why didn't you tell... I beg your pardon, miss.
Dad, this is Pat, the girl I was telling you about. I want you to meet her.
Well, sure, son, as soon as I get halfway presentable.
Well, let's go in the living room. Honey, sit down.
No, I'm fine, thanks. Golly, this is beautiful. Maybe Chet and I had had something like this instead of...
Honey, we'll fix it. Dad, this is Pat.
How do you do, Mr. Craig?
How do you do?
Nicky and I have been talking about meeting you. Now I don't know what to say.
Pat, I like you already. Sit down.
You have a beautiful home.
Thank you. Nothing fancy. Where do you live?
Oh, it's nothing fancy.
Mike, you may have your faults, but Pat certainly isn't one of them. You come from a large family, Pat?
No, just me and my brother, Chet.
Chet? Mike, when are you going to learn to make a proper introduction? I don't even know Pat's last name.
It's Marco, Mr. Craig. Patricia Ann Marco.
Play piano, Pat?
Well, I used to, a little.
Mike's mother played beautifully. Would you excuse me a moment? Well, honey, how do you like him?
Oh, he knows about me.
Oh, Mike, can I see you a minute?
Everything's gonna be fine.
Sure, Dad. I know what you're going to say, but I wanted you to get to know her before I told you she was Duke's sister.
I don't like it. Does she know I was a witness?
Dad, I'll tell her when the time is right.
Mike, I'm not a prudish man, but this girl's brother was a killer. How much do you know about her? How serious is this relationship?
It's real serious. And, Dad, please, let me handle it my way.
Look,
Dad,
Mike,
please, my way.
Son, this is going to cause us all a great deal of heartaches. But all right, your way.
Okay, honey, party time.
Show you the grounds.
I'll bet. I'm thirsty. Let's go get some punch.
Hello.
you some food?
No, I know some of the kids around here. Why don't I just walk around?
Well, at least you could have worn a tie.
Chet, have fun.
Oh, Chet, old man. Glad you could make it. We thought you might turn us down or something.
Yeah, well, thanks for inviting me, Arthur.
I wouldn't have missed this whole thing for the world. Well, thank Mickey. It was his idea. Bring a date?
No, my girl's a little unpredictable. You never know where she might show up.
But you've got to keep your eyes open, old man. Have you two met?
Yeah, I think so. I think I've seen her around.
And I wouldn't want to hold you up, Chet. Why not circulate a little bit?
Yeah. I'll see you around.
Pat, I want to talk to you. Now listen, and listen carefully. My father was the one that saw Duke kill that other man. He was the prosecution's eyewitness.
Oh, Mickey.
Yeah, this has been driving me nuts trying to tell you.
I don't know what to say. I feel numb. I don't feel angry or hurt. It doesn't matter. I know he did what he had to.
Marry me.
Yes, sir.
Talk to old friends?
Why are you doing this to me?
Doing what?
Trying to ruin everything for me.
Now, you know I wouldn't do that. You want a little drink?
No, I don't want any.
You know, this is a dull party. And I'm bored. And if you don't take a little drink, I might be more bored. And I might spoil something.
You can't stand the thought that I can even look at somebody else.
Don't flatter yourself, baby. I hate him, but not because of you.
Because you can't be trusted.
I'm crushed.
Look, Chet, I don't want you anymore. I want this. All of this.
Pebbles will bounce off these windows just as well now, won't they?
No, Chet, you were not here.
Why not? I'm sure Arthur won't mind. He's a swell guy.
I'm gonna go round, 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 round everywhere.
Yeah.
Danvers.
Yes,
Danvers.
Yes,
okay.
Yes, yes.
I know you got a problem with the whole not being psycho enough, all that fresh air out
I
there.
I know, it's just so relaxing.
Well, tell you what we're going to do. Here in the lab, the Tory, not lavatory, but you know, that's the bathroom. This is
yes,
the laboratory.
Laboratory.
Exactly. Anyway, I'm going to mix up some things because, you know, with the whole anatomy of a psycho thing.
Yes.
You have to know exactly where to reach
yes.
that spot. Now, this is where most normal people are, right here.
Right.
We need you to be... back here somewhere.
Back here,
yes, back here. So, there's two alternatives, really.
Yes.
One, we take a drill.
Okay.
Or nail, which
yes.
whatever one's handy. Rusty is the best.
Of course.
And then we take it and we go like that.
Ooh, ooh. Ooh,
that's a beginning.
Yes,
it's a beginning.
Yes,
but now the second alternative is to mix up chemicals.
Chemicals are always good.
Exactly.
Yes, yes.
There has been so many psychotic breaks in human beings because of chemicals.
Yes, yes.
So I figure, in our case, being monsters and psychos and madmen.
Yes.
That chemicals will probably reverse your sanity and make it back
that makes
into it.
Perfect sense.
Okay,
yes.
I'm so glad.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Was it made up at all?
Well,
no.
Yes.
Yeah.
No. What? Where am I?
You're Gargoyle Manor, the monster.
Oh,
you're
that's right.
Right.
You know, it's
I'm
that
Bobby Gammonster. You're Danvers.
That's right.
Remember?
That's right.
Okay.
It's all that fresh air. And so I've
anyway.
Little.
Yeah,
bump on the head
we'll
there,
mix,
doesn't
we'll mix,
it? Yes.
Yes. We'll mix these two
ooh, ooh.
Like that.
Ooh, yes. I
like
that.
That.
Yes.
Okay. And,
yes.
And. Okay.
Yes, yes,
now,
yes.
Swirl it around a little bit.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Ready?
Yes.
All right.
All right. All right. All right. I'm going to just. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Ooh. I feel really good. I'm sorry that I messed up your sign.
No, you didn't.
There.
You just got taller
but,
for
well,
some reason.
Well, I did.
It was like you were short, and then you sprang
yeah,
up
just,
with the whole.
You know,
but do you feel?
Oh, it's perfect. The insanity potion, lotion, whatever. Yeah. It you know, it makes you a little taller. It makes you feel a little
really?
Bit more, you know. You should try it.
I am going to.
Oh, yes. Oh.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, dear. Oh, okay. Well, that
this
is very
beautiful.
Good.
Is that velvet?
It is. It's from the coffin, just so you know.
Oh, yes. Well, I guess, you know, I feel like brand new, but we should probably, just to make sure, get back to anatomy of a psycho.
Exactly. So
yes.
Let's go back to it.
Enjoy.
Enjoy. And get a little, you know, crazy and
yes.
weird. Get some of those. No, don't get the chemicals. Don't you do it. No one does it unless you have a license. We do. I do. We have licenses. Don't try it at home.
Right here in the lavatory.
Exactly. Let's go.
Sandra? Sandra!
Arthur, let me explain, please.
What's troubling you, Arthur boy?
I'm gonna kill you.
Yeah.
No, Arthur! Arthur, no, please don't fight me. Jeff, leave me alone. Arthur, please let me. Arthur, darling, I'm sorry, Arthur. I didn't mean it, Arthur, please. I didn't mean it. Arthur, please. Arthur, please, Arthur.
Yeah.
Too bad about that fire, though.
What fire?
Well, now, you must have heard the engines go by, didn't you?
I just got out of the movies.
Oh. You didn't hear anything about it, huh?
No, Lieutenant. Honest.
It was Judge Brennan's house.
Was anybody hurt?
No. No one hurt.
Chet.
Have a nice time at the party?
You get around, don't you, Mac?
Well, Judge is a very important man, you know.
To a two-bit cop?
Chet, I think I'll see you back at the shack. Easy, Bobby.
Listen, Chet. I don't know who set that fire. Right now, it's an impossible thing to tell, but let me tell you this. You better straighten out before you can't anymore. You get some kind of hate gnawing at you. And if you're not careful, it's going to tear you apart insides. I've seen it happen before.
Look, Mac. When you can put the old braces on me, come and get me, huh? Until then, stay off of my back.
Be sorry they were ever born.
Who?
All of them. Bobby, I don't want you hanging around me anymore.
What are you mad at me for?
There's gonna be trouble.
Chet, why are you doing all this?
You know why? They killed Duke. See, I never knew my father or my mother. All I had was Duke. They took him away and they killed him. What am I supposed to do? Let him kick me too? Yeah, they'd like that. You know that party I was at today at the judge's house? They had things there that cost more than Duke ever begged, borrowed, or stole in his whole life. Any one of those lousy paintings or statues.
You know what you said about needing someone to look up to? Trusting somebody? Well, I guess you're the one I look up to and trust.
You've got to get out of here.
What do you want now, punk?
No trouble from you. I want to talk to Chet.
Look, I told you I didn't want you around here. Now get out of here.
Gently, Mo.
Chet, let's take a ride or something.
Leave me alone.
Chet, Pat and I are getting married.
Marry her, but don't talk to me about it.
Chet, come on with me. You'll feel a lot better. Look, listen to me, Chet. I've got to tell you something that's going to hurt. The eyewitness at your brother's trial was my father. He had to tell the truth. Try to understand, Chet.
Duke? Duke, did you hear that? And you're gonna marry Pat!
Get out of my way, Mo.
I've been waiting for this.
Duke!
We better get a doctor.
Everything's gonna be all right, Mo.
Help me. Help me. Get a doctor.
Everything's gonna be all right.
Help me, Ted. Mo. Don't pull the knife out or I'll bleed to death. Get a doctor.
Nothing, you hear me? Think, Bobby. Think. Everything's gonna be all right. Do you hear? Just fine.
But he wouldn't let me. He's moved to the shack.
I feel sorry for Chet.
After what he's done to you?
Honey, he's so mixed up. They're bound to see it. Have you seen my dad?
Almost every day.
Stick with him. It's a very rough time for him.
Of course I will. Maybe this will all be over in a couple of weeks and seem like a bad dream. I love you. I wish you were holding me in your arms right now.
Honey, I am.
Now open and in session. The Honorable Albert J. Riley presiding.
Are you ready, Mr. Baker?
Yes, Your Honor. The state calls Detective Lieutenant William McGowan.
Lieutenant William McGowan, will you come forward and be sworn? You do solemnly swear by the ever-living God that the testimony you are about to give in the case now in hearing before the court shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
I do.
You see it.
Lieutenant, do you recall an argument you witnessed at the home of Mo Caruso between the defendant, Mickey Craig, and the deceased on the afternoon of the deceased's death?
Yes, sir, if it can be called an argument.
Would you explain to the court the circumstances leading to that altercation?
Well, when I got there, the defendant was already getting ready to leave. He told Mo that he looked forward to meeting him again.
Would you say that Mickey Craig's tone was friendly when he said this?
No, not exactly. It was some kind of threat, all right, but not anything you take seriously.
Obviously, you were wrong, Lieutenant.
Objection! Sustained. The reporter will strike the prosecutor's last remark from the records, and the jury is instructed to disregard the remark.
Did the defendant say anything else?
Yes, he said that if Mo ever mentioned Pat's name again, that he, the deceased, would see him again sooner than he might expect. And then Mo told Mickey never to come back to his house again, and Mickey left.
Did Mo say anything to you?
Yes. He said he might need my protection, but I thought he was joking.
You've made that quite clear, Lieutenant.
Bobby, how long have you known Chet Marco?
Nearly 3 years.
When was the first time you went to Moe's shack?
About the same time as I met Chet.
Was Chet the person who first brought you there?
Yes, sir.
Would you say that of all the boys in the shack, Chet was your best friend?
Yes.
Would you say that Chet Marco was your best friend? Including all the boys at school, or anywhere else for that matter.
I guess so.
Bobby, do you understand the meaning of the word perjury?
Yes, sir. Means lying under oath.
Do you further understand that it's a felony for which a person can go to jail for several years or longer?
I know.
I ask you then to tell the facts as they really happened, rather than attempting to corroborate the testimony of your friend Chet Marco.
I told the truth. Everything Chet said was the way it happened.
Hello everyone, I'm Danvers, and I'm here in the Monster Museum with Bobby Gammonster, and you're watching Monster Movie Night.
I know it's easy to say, but try not to be discouraged, huh?
Okay, Mike.
And I'll see you as soon as I can.
Right.
Carl, I'm frightened. Every piece of testimony is being twisted to make Mike look guilty.
It's all right, Frank. We've still got a chance.
Well, what happened to Bobby?
I don't know. I couldn't get to him. He doesn't have enough motive for lying.
Chet's our only chance, huh?
Yes, but I'll crack him yet.
Think you can do it?
I'll keep him on the stand a week if I have to.
Week.
In your own words, Miss Marco, would you tell the court what Mickey said?
Mickey said that he was going up to the shack to see Chet. That he wanted to tell him that we were going to get married.
Yes.
And to tell him that his father was key witness at Duke's trial.
And so when Chet testified earlier that Mickey came to the shack to fight with Mo, he was not telling the truth.
Your Honor, I object.
In your opinion.
No, he was lying. Chet, please, please tell him the truth. Please.
Order. Counsel will instruct the witness. No further questions, Your Honor. Your witness.
Now, Miss Marco, I agree that someone is lying in this trial. You were not at the shack at the time of Moe's death. Consequently, you, like the rest of us, can determine only in your own mind the events of that evening through the testimony presented in this trial.
I know Mickey wouldn't lie.
You know the witness, Bobby Brown?
Yes.
Have you ever known him to lie?
Well, Bobby's all mixed up. He thinks he's helping Chet.
Why would he want to help Chet?
Well, because he likes Chet. Because Chet's been sort of like an older brother to him.
Then you'll agree with me that an honest person might lie, even under oath, to protect someone whom they love?
Yes, that's why Bobby's lying.
And don't you have an even greater motive for lying than Bobby, Miss Marco?
No.
Aren't you in love with the defendant?
Yes.
Aren't you planning to marry the defendant?
I'm telling the truth. You're twisting everything I'm saying. Oh, Vicky, you want to be tried to settle.
And you still insist that Moe's death was an accident?
That's the way it happened. I picked up the knife so Moe wouldn't get it. He jumped at me and fell on the knife.
Are you aware that the deceased was an ex-Marine?
Yes, sir.
And you are also aware that he had undergone intensive hand-to-hand combat training?
I guess so.
And yet you want this court to believe that a man with his training and his struggle with you was so careless as to inflict a fatal wound on himself?
That's the way it happened.
If it was an accident, why did you run out? Why didn't you call a doctor?
I was scared. I guess I panicked.
Yes, you were frightened. And I submit, with good reason. Now, Mr. Marco, let's get a few facts straight, shall we?
Yes, sir.
Let's take the night in question. When Mickey Craig came to the shack.
Isn't it true that when Mickey told you that it was his father who'd been the witness at your brother's trial, you started raving and calling your dead brother? And that you then proceeded to beat Mickey with your fists?
No, sir.
Didn't you scream to your brother in this manner, Duke, I've got the witness, I've got the witness?
My brother's dead. And is it also true that when Mickey tried to leave, he was intercepted by Moe, and in the ensuing struggle, Moe was accidentally killed?
I wish it were true. You see, Mickey's my friend, and he's going to marry my sister. I wish we could all go home now, that Moe was still alive instead of being dead. But Moe is dead, and I can't lie. So everything I said on this stand is the truth.
Didn't you swear to get revenge on the men you held responsible for your brother's execution?
No. I was sore at first. But then I realized my brother got full justice of the court. And I'm not sore at anybody anymore.
Order! Order!
The defense rests, Your Honor.
You may step down, please.
Gentlemen of the jury, have you selected your foreman?
Yes, I'm foreman of the jury. Have you arrived at your verdict?
Yes, Your Honor.
You will please pass your verdict to the bailiff. You will listen to the reading of your verdict. We find the defendant, Michael Craig, guilty of first-degree murder. The case will be continued, and the defendant returned to the court for sentencing on September 28th. The court is now adjourned.
I'm going to stay on this case even if I have to do it on my own time.
Mac, you got me over a barrel. I convicted that boy.
Well, you had me over a barrel on that stand out there. Oh, it's your job, all right. I understand that. But the fact is, I helped you convict that boy, and I don't think he's guilty.
Mac, the case is closed.
Well, then, good day, Mr. District Attorney.
Here now.
A dead man in a dead house, huh?
What do you want?
This place used to be nice. Had some good laughs in it.
You got a search warrant?
No. No, you're right, I haven't. I'm breaking the law. And when a cop starts to break the law, a person should be very careful.
I don't scare, Mac.
No, I guess you don't. You've got a lot of guts, haven't you? You proved that on the stand.
out. Out of my house.
Marco. Marco, you lied on that stand. I told the truth and it made your lie look even better.
You want to punch me out, Mac? Go ahead.
I'm going to break you. I don't care where you go or what you do. I'm going to be there. You see, that kid may die, but you're going to wish he hadn't.
Mac.
Now, Pat, don't talk like that. We're still trying. Where to now?
Oh, home, I guess.
All right, except that I'd like to talk to Chet for a few minutes. You want to come along?
Well, I'll go with you, but I don't want to talk to him. I don't even want to see him.
All right. I'll just be a few minutes, then I'll take you home, all right?
Pat?
Yeah, I talk to her every day. She's a fine girl, Mike. Carl's working hard to get an appeal. I'm sure he'll get it.
Sure he will, Dad.
You know something? I keep thinking, if I'd only kept my mouth shut at Duke Marco's trial, none of this would have happened.
Dad, Duke was guilty. I'm innocent. You do believe me, don't you, Dad?
Never doubt that, Mike.
Dad, tomorrow they're going to tell me whether I spend the rest of my life in prison or die in the gas chamber. Dad, I'm scared.
Mr. Craig?
At me.
Where are you going, Chet?
Never mind. Look, go someplace, huh? To a movie?
All right, Pat. I'll only be a minute.
Is it all right if I go in there and see Chet alone? Please.
You sure that's what you want to do?
Yeah.
Okay, Pat.
Out of here, Pat.
Not till you hear what I have to say to you.
I'm not interested in what you have to say to me.
Mickey forgives you, Chet. He doesn't even blame you. He asked me to get you to a doctor before it's too late. Isn't that a riot, Chet? Before it's too late.
I'll tell you what's a riot. Mickey, you, Mac, you all think I'm cracked. Look around. You don't see no bars here.
Oh, yes, I do, Chet. Twisted and gnarled inside that brain. I'm finally beginning to understand what Mickey meant. You know, I'm not like him, Chet. I can't forgive you so easily. I'm glad you're going to live your life twisted up inside.
You finished?
Yes, I'm finished. Whether Mickey dies in a gas chamber or spends the rest of his life in that prison cell, my life is finished. The only thing I can do is hate you with all my heart as long as I live.
Get out.
I feel sorry for you, Bobby. I hope someday you wake up and understand what you've helped him to do.
Patty,
get out of here!
You know what I want, and I'll get it out of you if I have to kill you.
Mr. Craig!
Get out of here, both of you!
Stop it! Stop it!
Leave me, Mr. Craig. He's not worth it.
Chet, leave me alone. Just leave me alone. Get out. All of you, get out.
Chet. I won't tell him. You know I won't tell him. But you do it. Do it for me. Tell him. Tell him the truth. Anymore.
I know, Bobby. Bobby, I want you to tell me the truth. Chet killed Mo, didn't he?
Yes.
Thank you.
do nothing.
I don't want to. But I'm a cop, and I will if I have to.
You better not hurt me.
I won't hurt you, Jen.
You better not. Nothing.
Come on, Chet. Come on, boy. You can trust me, Chet. I promise you we'll help you, Chet.
Don't you hurt me.
You can trust me, boy. Not gonna hurt you, see?
Better not hurt me.
No, I won't. Let's go.
You better not.
No, I won't hurt you, Chet. You can trust me, you know that.
Matt, help me, Matt.
I'll help you, Chet. You'll get help.
Well, folks, wasn't that a great film?
It was fantastic. It was just what I needed to give me the old, like, jolt back into my own reality.
So you feel more psycho than ever, right?
Oh, it's fantastic. I can't wait to get back to the asylum and just stir up trouble for everyone. I love this cop.
It sort of changed from when you first came in, but that's much better looking.
It needs more belladonna.
I'm sure. Oh yeah, we'll find. Oh, right there in the skull.
Ooh,
yeah,
perfect.
Yes, we're just gonna get some of that.
I'll do it later. Let's
okay,
just finish. Yes,
fine. Okay, yeah.
It's all props and all of that.
Props.
So.
This is my home.
Okay. And you were a great help too.
Well.
Yes.
Yeah. He thanks you, don't you, boy?
Yes.
Well, anyway. Well, I thank you for coming out, and so glad we could help you.
Oh, absolutely. There's nothing like Bobby Gammonster to, help a friend out.
Well, same back at you there, Dan.
There we go.
Same back at you. And anyway, for you guys out there, I hope you are psycho enough to be able to handle this film and the two of us together again.
Yes.
Well, look under your beds. Look in your closets. Bobby Gammonster, Danvers, may be there, along with Boris. And if not, remember, until next time, keep screaming.
Stay crazy.